Good afternoon to all. Today we are discussing about laws of motion. The chapter is laws of motion, Newton's first law from 9th class. Myself, D. Rajender, School Assistant Physical Science, JPHS Muthankal, Suryapet. First of all, how the objects or bodies are moving, how they are moving and how they are stopped, what is the position of that object? These questions are all clarified by the great ancient scientist Aristotle. From our scientist, he says that the natural state of an earthly object at rest requires no explanation, as any moving body naturally comes to rest. What is the natural state of an object if you left itself? Means it will become to rest. If you stop pedaling of a bicycle, it gradually slow down and last come into rest. In this way, he explained the position of or state of an object. After that, the scientist Galileo done some experiments from some height of the buildings, and also he observed so many moving objects, and also he done two experiments. After that, he states that Galileo states that an object in motion will remain in same motion as long as no external force is applied to it. The object is in the same motion as long as no external force is applied to it. For this, he done two experiments. The two experiments, one is on inclined planes with a smooth surface, and observe that the smoother the surface, the farther the ball travel. In this way, he explained this. If a ball release from an inclined plane which is having a smooth surface, it will be travels same height to that another side. If you change the angle of plane, and also it will be reached to the same height, but it is traveled some more distance or farther. If the inclined angle is infinite, then it will be travels continuously, remains move. If the surface was perfectly smooth, the ball will travel indefinitely until encountered by another object. This is the first experiment done by the Galileo Galilei. Now we are observing one video from here. How the inclined plane experiment done, we will see this. A heavy ball taken and a smooth surfaced slant plane wooden blocks taken. If releasing of a ball from a inclined plane, due to the gravitation force, it will be travels and reaches to the other side. If you observe, the initial height is h1 and the final height is the H2. There is a little bit change, or there is a little bit difference. Why this difference is occurs means the frictional force is applied on the ball, so that's why the height will be differs. The height is difference can be reduced by the lubricating the planes. If you take a ideal plane, means frictionless plane, then it will be reach same height. If you take a frictionless plane, then it will be reach the same height. Now we are change the angle of a plane. If you observe here, the angle will be reduced. Then the ball is released from a certain height first initially. It will be reaches that same height when the plane is frictionless. But the distance covered or traveled by the object is more. If you reduce the angle for infinite, then the ball is released from the certain height. Due to the gravitation force, it will be moves and reaches to the same height, but it will be, for the getting of the same height, it will be rotate. It will be in motion continuously. So he said that a force is caused to the motion of an object. Here we are observing a ball is in the rest position. When you apply the force, it will be moves. If a ball is moving, when you apply the force, it will be stop. And when you apply the force, then it will be stops. Here we are observing another ball. It will be spin. If you apply the upward force and downward force, then the ball will be rotate. Then it will be spin. In the cricket, we will be observe that the spin of the ball. So here, this like he explained that the cause of the object is that the cause for the motion is that. Applying of the force. In this way, he explained the cause about the cause to that ball is in the figure 1A. The Galileo observed that a marble rolls down due to the force of gravity and reaches the earth. In the above figure 1B, it will be reaches less distance due to the opposite force, that is frictional force. When marble rolls up an inclined plane, its speed is decreases. If a plane is horizontal to the surface, then it will be in the motion uniformly. It has no reason to speed or slow, so it will be continue to move with constant velocity. In the textbook, there is given these three figures for that. We have already watched that video. A marble is rolled down due to the gravitational force on a frictionless plane. It will be reached to that same height. If you decrease or reduce the angle, then also it will be reaches to the same height, but it will be travels far area. It will be travels more area. If the inclined plane angle is indefinite, infinite, then the ball will be continuously roll up and it will be in the uniform motion. In this way, done the experiment on inclined planes about the motion of the objects. So the marble released from its initial height rolled down due to the force of gravity and then moves up the slope until it reaches its initial height. If change the angle of slope, figure B to B, the marble rolled up the same height, but it had to go farther in this instance. That means the distance traveled by marble is greater. It continues by reducing angle of slope, same result comes. How far must it have to move to reach the same height? If it has no slope to go up. Conclusion. From this experiment, we can conclude. What is the conclusion means? The natural state of a moving object, if it is free of external influences, it is uniform motion. If there is no external force, it will be continuously moving, moving, moving. If any external force influences, then object comes to rest. After this, the another great scientist, Sir Isaac Newton, is explained the motion of the object in the three laws that are known as Newton laws of motions. These three laws are explained by the scientist Sir Isaac Newton. Sir Isaac Newton proposed his three fundamental laws which explain the connection between force and a change in motion. These three laws are popularly known as Newton's laws of motion. Here, there is an activity. That activity we know very well. An object at rest, it tries to or stays to rest only. If an object in the motion, it will be tries to stay in that motion only until applying the external force. For example, a fan is rotating. If you switch off the electric power, then it will be continually rotating for a fraction of seconds. As well as if you're running on a ground, you won't be suddenly stopped. You will be moved a little bit forward. Means if an object in the rest position, it will be tries to stay in the rest position only. If an object in the uniform motion, it will be tries to stay in that uniform motion unless an external force is applied. For this explaining, we have done an experiment here. Newton's first law states that an object at rest will remain at rest, and an object moving at a constant velocity will continue moving at a constant velocity unless it is acted upon by an unbalanced force. An object in motion will stay in motion in the same direction until acted on by an opposing force. That opposing force will be unbalanced force. Here we are observing a football. First, the ball is in the rest position. When the external force is applied, then the ball comes into the motion. It will be continually motion. in that motion only. Same direction. When the net is applies an external unbalanced force, then the ball will be comes into the rest position. Only the force is caused to that motion of the object. This is explained by the Sir Isaac Newton in his first law of motion. Now we see here, an object will not change its motion unless acted on by an unbalanced force. Unbalanced force means, we learn that net force in that eighth class. If the two opposite forces are equal, then the net force is zero. So that's why there is no influence on that object, so it will be not change its state. So unbalanced force means some net force will be apply on that object, then it will be changed the state of the object. So that's why the Newton first law says that inertia is the property of matter by virtue of which an object continues its existing state of rest or uniform motion in a straight line unless an external force changes that state. This is known as the law of inertia. Objects will stay in motion or at rest until acted upon by a force. If you taking two types of objects, one is having 300 kg and one is having 30 kg. If you apply the same force on the two bodies, the 300 kg object doesn't change its state, but 30 kg object will be changed its state, because it is a 300 kg object having more mass. Here another example we will be observe that there is a jeep and a small car. For that two vehicles, if you want to change the position of these two vehicles, you will be apply more force on the jeep. Why? Because it is having more mass. As well as another one is there. One is empty bucket and another one is having full of sand. Which one you feel difficult to move means the sand bucket. Why? Because it is having more more weights or more mass. So that's why we can't get that. We can't change the state of the object. So the mass of the object is very important. So the natural tendency of the object to resist a change in their state or rest of uniform motion is called inertia. The Newton first law known as also law of inertia. So the inertia is depends upon the mass of the object. There are three types of inertias are there. One is inertia of rest, that is known as static inertia. Second one is inertia of motion, that is known as dynamic inertia. Third one is that inertia of direction. Here we are observing the static inertia and the dynamic inertia. Static inertia means the object is in the rest position. It will be tries to stay in that rest position only. Dynamic inertia, in this, the object is in the uniform motion or in the motion. It will be tries to stay in that uniform motion or motion. It is known as dynamic inertia. If you are moving giant wheel, is rotating on an axis by the applying of the force, it will be continuously stay in that uniform motion only. If you apply that external force, then it will be tries to in that motion, so it will be continually move some fraction of seconds. And inertia of direction means if the bus is suddenly turns to left side, you will be fall to right side. If the bus is turns to right side, you will be fall to left side. This is the inertia of direction. In our textbook, there is an experiment is there. That experiment is activity 3. Here we will be take an cardboard and a coin, 5 rupees coin or a 1 rupee coin, and a glass. You put that glass and put that cardboard on that glass and keep the coin on that cardboard. These 3 objects in the rest position only. So these 3 objects tries to stay in that rest position only. When you apply the external unbalanced force on that cardboard, due to the applying of the unbalanced force, it will be moves. But the coin is in the rest position. Due to the inertia, it will be tries to stay in that rest position only. So the cardboard will be go outside and the coin remains stay in the rest. So that's why it will be fall into the glass due to the gravitational force. Same like that, if you done this experiment with egg also, and if you vibrating a branch of the tree, then the fruits will be fall down. If you beat a carpet with a stick, the dust particles will be comes outside due to the inertia of rest. Here we are observing this type of static inertia. We will be see some more examples when you dust is removed from a hanging carpet by beating with a stick. If the bus is suddenly moves, we will be jerked to the background. Why? Because before of the bus moving, we are all in the rest position. Suddenly the bus is moving due to the mechanical force. We are in the rest position initially. So that's why we try to in the rest position only. So that's why we will be jerked backward. The dynamic inertia. If the bus is moving forward, and that means it is in the motion, we are also in that motion. Suddenly, the driver applies the brake. Due to the applying of the force, the bus is stopped. But passengers are moving with uniform motion, so they are tries to in that motion only. So that's why they are moving forward. If the bus is suddenly brake, we will be keeps moving forward. This is due to the dynamic inertia. Here, when the net force acting on a body is 0, that the body is in equilibrium. Now, activity 1 we are observing here. Observing the motion of a coin kept on a thick paper. Take a thick paper or cardboard, keep it on a glass tumbler. Now, take a coin and kept it on the center of the paper. Now, push the paper gently. Then the coin will be dropped into the glass due to the rest, inertia of rest. Or observing the motion of the coin hit by a striker. We are observing in the carom board. if you strike a coin, it will be remain rest, and another coin will be move and falls into the hole or slides down. We can find that the bottom coin will be removed from the stack and the other in the stack will be slide down. Here is another activity. If you take two blocks, one is having less mass and another one is having more mass. These two blocks put on a plane area and give a line to them. And take a metal scale or wooden scale and push the two blocks with a uniform or similar force on both blocks. Then we observe that the two bodies are not moving samely. One is moving less distance and another one is moving long distance. Whatever, the small block will be goes farther and the bigger block goes less distance. Why? Because the big block having more mass, so that's why it is having more inertia, and the small block having less mass, so that's why it is having less inertia. So the inertia is depends upon the mass of the object. Through this observation, you can tell that the greater the mass of an object, the more it resists the change in its state of motion. So mass is a property of an object that specifies how much inertia the object has. Inertia is depends on mass. So units of inertia is kg. Here, car is having 1000 kgs and a lorry having 9,856 kgs. Which one is having more inertia means the lorry is having more mass, so it will be resist the change in its states of motion is more. So it is having more inertia of rest. So inertia is depends upon the mass. So that's why the lorry having more inertia. So inertia is depends upon the mass. So that why, so that's why inertia having the units as kgs. Here is a small question in our textbook. A body of mass m is kept on a horizontal floor and it is pushed in the horizontal direction with a force of 10 newtons continuously so that it moves steadily. We learn that free body diagram, and how many forces are applying on that object, that forces are all drawn, that is known as free body diagram. We learn in this 8th class about that free body diagram. So by using this free body diagram, we calculate this and we can solve the problem. What is the value of friction? Here, the body of mass M is kept on a horizontal floor and it is also moving horizontally steadily. This word is very important. Now we are observing that the weight of the object is downward due to the gravitational force, that is known as weight. We draw that W downwardly. For this force, the normal force is applies. So the normal force is drawn upward that is M. And by applying the force, it will be moving horizontally steadily. So the applying of the force we drawn horizontally, that is F. While the object is moving on the surface, the frictional force is opposed to the motion of the object. So the frictional force is drawn with opposite arrow mark, that is small f. Here the word is given that steadily means the net force is zero. And how much of the force is applied on that object, that much of the frictional force is also applied. So that's why we taken that capital F is equal minus F. Capital F plus minus F is equal zero. So F plus minus F. Why are you writing here minus? Means it is opposite direction. So that's why we're giving minus symbol. So capital F plus minus F is equal to zero. So the force applied on the object is equivalent to the frictional force. So capital F is equal to small f. Here the force is applying given as 10 newtons. So that's why the frictional force is also a 10 newtons. In this way, we are calculating the frictional force by using the free body diagram. Now we are observing a video about the inertia. Inertia is a property of a object. This depends upon the mass of the object. Now we are observing that here inertia. Inertia is the first law of motion. It is explained by the Newton. So an object is at rest, stays at rest, and an object in motion stays in motion with the same speed and same direction unless acted upon by an unbalanced force. Objects tend to keep on its initial position only. Here we are observing a football. It is in the rest position. Due to the inertia, it will be tries to in the rest position only. But we are applying an unbalanced force, then it will be change its state's rest position to uniform motion, and it will be getting some velocity. Here we are observing different masses of the objects. So all are having same inertia. No, these objects are all having different masses, so that's why they are having also different inertias. Here a wooden block, one is a smaller one, one is a bigger one. By pushing of these two wooden blocks with same velocity, bigger block will have more resist to move. So that's why it will be having more inertia. Means bigger wooden block having more inertia due to the more mass. So that's why the object having more mass means it is having more inertia. That means inertia is depends upon the mass of the object. So that's why the units of inertia is having the units as kgs. The experiment we are observing, activity 3, take a glass tumbler and a paper and a coin. If you push that paper, the coin will be remain in rest of inertia, so it will be drop into that glass. These are three experiments for rest of inertias. the cardboards are pushed by some external force. They are moving, but the glasses are in the rest position. So due to the rest of inertia of rest, they will be fall into the pot. Here, the experiment of a carrom board. If you strike the red coin, only that red coin will be goes outside, and the remain coins will be same. And once again, we strike that black coin. Now observing here, if you strike that beneath of the coins, that black coin, if you strike, it will be only most due to the applying of the external force. Remain will be change doesn't change due to the inertia of rest. Now, if you are applying the force on a white coin, it will be only moves. The remaining coins will be in the same position due to the inertia of rest. In this way, we can observe the inertia of bodies from our first lesson, and from our lesson that is first law of motion. Okay, thank you.